There we go. All right, what's up, people? I am doing this. I've been meaning to do this for a while. And basically... Wow. Dropping my stuff here. I'm going through my computer build that I just completed recently. I just did it actually yesterday. But since I don't have a good quality camera, what I decided to do... I had two things. I don't have a quality camera that I could use with the computer, so I had to actually download all this footage that I have. The other thing was that I didn't have commentary prepared, and there was a lot of noise going on in the background, so it was impossible for me to record audio that goes along with its footage. So I thought my idea was, let me record the footage and then go through it. Oh, gnats. You're so crazy. So here's a chassis. This is what I started with. It's a Antec 900. And it's a little bit more, it's a modern PC case, but let's say it's a little bit older, so it doesn't have some of the very up to the minute changes on it, and I had to make a little bit of a compromise on certain things. But it's still a good case. So let's get right into it here. And this is the back of the case. And one of the things you'll notice is it doesn't have a lot of routing for cables. So that's one of the challenges of this case. But it has a lot of good positive things about it. You can see it has a cutout for the PC. And, let's see. Shut the fuck up. Indeed. So let's go on to the next thing. Let's get right into it. So, I started with the Gigabyte G1 Sniper Z97 motherboard. And the reason why I chose this motherboard is just because of the brand. The quality of the components is supposed to be durable components. It's a game keyboard, so it has the features that I'm looking for. Obviously, it supports the RAM, the DDR3 RAM, and the high-end i5 processor that we're using. And thank you guys for coming and stopping by, checking out my PC build that I'm doing here. I'm doing live commentary on footage that I made actually yesterday. And so it's a live ready board, you know, you can put two cards in it, you know, it's very modern. It has a thing that I liked about it is that it has a sound blaster on board. It's like a quad core sound processing audio, you know, all the little things, the gold plating on the things so they don't wear out on the ports and things of that nature. So it's just a quality board, it looks nice, goes along with my theme, just so happens to go with the black and red theme. So here you see what we have, actually the motherboard itself, I've laid it out. You can see how nice it is. It's got actually an LED readout, power switch, reset switch on board. Came with very nice accessories like these little stickers that you can put for the hard drive. So it's like a complete package, you know. Easy to hook everything up to. Lots of room to work with, you know, it's very well thought out. Let's move on to the next thing that I have here. Okay, so here's our i5 processor. It's a 4690K, which means it's an unlocked processor. This is going to allow me to tune the processor. Actually, you can, you know, add more voltage to it. you know, speed up the clock if you want to, basically overclock it. So that's a possibility, especially with the cooling setup that I'm going to be demonstrating and showing off to you guys, and what I decided to go with for this case. Let's see what we got now. So basically what I'm getting into is I've got the motherboard laid out on the cardboard that came inside the box. I'm going to start building it. Now we're not using that stock heatsink. I'm just showing what came in the box, okay? So we're storing that. That might be used for another project or something. A lot of people turn them into coasters.
You killed the pet worm.
Thank you. Thank you for that follow. Let me see what it says here in the chat. I need to know how to get and understand.
SDSuka has just followed.
Appreciate that, SDSuka. Nice to have you in the wolf pack, or the, let's see, I'm trying to understand PC desktop monitors and setups right now. I'm looking forward to getting a setup and the stuff, trying to get a good PC. I know nothing about this stuff. And I'd like to have one. Okay, well, I'll definitely answer your questions and stuff. I'm gonna keep going through this. Stick around, and
I'll.
I appreciate that follow. my Gears of War themed sounds are going off. Prime Killers, what's up? Prime Killers is one of our hardcore stream supporters. He's been here since like day one. Appreciate him coming by. Just wanted to shout out to him. Let's go on to the next piece of video that we have. So again, this is our motherboard. It's a G1 gaming series. And basically what we're doing here is we're opening up our little, our processor. I'm doing my PC build here. Our processor socket is being opened up here. You know, this is the zero force insertion that of today's standard. You know, you lift this arm up, lift this latch up, and the actually you orient the processor. There are little keys, so you can't really install it the wrong way. There's only one way that it goes. Let's take a look here now. So here I think we're actually putting our processor in place. So again, you're gonna see a triangle, and that's gonna help you to orientate. Anyway, the orientation of the processor. So you see the keys, I'm showing it right now. The keys make it, and I'm gently making sure that it's in its correct place now. And the arrow is down left. So that's basically the way it goes. You slip the cover over, you put the little latches underneath the screw on the bottom, and actually I think you can close this down and the cover will pop off. My cover wasn't popping off, so here's what I did. I stopped right there, and I actually removed the cover myself, because it had already kind of popped, but it didn't go all the way. So I tried my best with the camera work, guys. I'm sorry about that. How much estimated beginning PC cost, essentially? Okay, well, I mean, you know, if you're building a custom PC, you want to have a nice budget, you know. You could easily do a $500-$600 PC build, and you could go wild and crazy, go up to $1,200 for a power PC. Now, you can see I just latched the processor down, just like that. So you could go $1,200 and have a really cutting edge PC that's gonna last you for a while, or you can even take it to the next level. You know, go $1,500-$1,600 and really trick it out. Lots of custom stuff. I'll talk about my budget and stuff and how I put this all together. But let's move on to the next thing. So here's our RAM that I decided to go with. It's a HyperX. This is a Kingston kit. So Kingston is a memory company that's been around a long time. I've had experience with them in the past. I like their HyperX series, a gaming series. This is a DDR3. I decided to go with 8 gigabytes of RAM. That's all I need. It's probably more than I need, actually. More than most people need. but I don't understand any of this stuff, but I'm still watching and I'm interested. Well, I'm glad you're watching. I hope you're enjoying it. I'm putting together this sick PC. It's going to be all put together after I go through all these videos. And I'll definitely, I mean, this is the magic. This is the kind of how you play PC games, you know? So it's kind of cool to understand the components, how it all comes together and what they do and what they work and how they work. I'd be more than happy to explain in a simple way, like what everything does and all that stuff. I love PCs ever since I was a kid. So here we have our unboxed RAM with a beautiful heat sink on it to pull heat away from them. I wish I understand. Okay. Well, I'll try to explain. I'm happy to talk with you guys and go through it, answer questions, and show off. So anyway, here's back to our motherboard. We're opening up our slots. It's paired RAM, so you need to. I consulted the motherboard manual, and basically that tells me that this is DIMM slot, you know, 1 and 2, or basically 0 and 1. So these are paired. They work together in a pair, and you have to use them. They're color-coded, black and or and gray. So the gray ones are the ones we're using for our build. So basically, we're going to take our RAM. It's keyed, so you can't put it in the wrong way. You're going to put it in the... There are two little forks on the edges that allow you to slip it in place, and you just firmly press it down. And you'll see those arms on the sides that will come and close down on there. That's how you know you gotta put it down flat and secure on both sides. And we're gonna put our second one, again, in the gray slot. I hope you like it. I'm happy you guys are joining me live. So, okay, we put our RAM in. So what I like to do is see how I put my fingers and I made sure they clicked all the way down. And I just double checked. I just put, you know, nice pressure on them, make sure they seated all the way. Because if your RAM doesn't seat, that could cause issues. You might just get a blank screen, it won't boot. So you want to be really, it's not hard. You just have to, you have to kind of just be paying attention when you're working on it, you know? So try not to get distracted and just focus on what you're working on piece by piece. Okay, check it out. Now, that was putting together the pieces on the motherboard. And now what we're jumping to is the I/O panel. So this is the panel that goes in the back of the PC that is gonna basically the motherboard is going to be put in place there, and I'll show you how it works. But essentially, when I install that piece into our chassis, okay, one of the things I wanted to demonstrate the quality of Gigabyte, they put these pads in there with a metallic film, something like that. And this is quality, this is what something that is not usually done in motherboards. So I just wanted to show you like why a quality company is what you want for a motherboard. You wanted to pay attention to details, and this is just one of the details that they have done very well. And this just softens it up, how it mates together with the motherboard, and it just makes the build easier, and it's just a higher quality build, okay? Let's take a look at the chat now. It's not that hard, you just have to make sure everything is compatible. Very good point, very good point. You can check compatibility. I'll do all that research ahead of time before you get all your parts. Yeah, I don't know how much I really need a new PC. I got the money for one. I just need some help with stuff. Okay, that's cool. Let's see, just do some research, more research. Where do you get research? So I'll talk about places where you can research. Definitely, like you're saying, YouTube, Google, ask some people that know. Those are all possibilities. Web forums are a good place as well. So here we're going in right into our Antec 900 PC case. I've customized this case myself. Actually, I didn't mention this. It's painted gold inside. It's a black armor on the outside with a gold on the inside. So we're putting our IO in place here in the back. It's designed to go in here, and it will click in place here. And I had a little bit of a tough time. You want to be really careful with this. I actually kind of bent it out a little bit because I was like, get in there, damn it. But that's essentially how it goes. But we popped it in place here. It'll pop, it'll click in place, and there it is sitting in the chassis. I straightened that little, I kind of bent it a little bit at the top because it's not very strong, the chassis there. But so I got it back straightened up. Everything looks beautiful, as you can see. Then we're going to take a look at the back. Now you can see how our IO panel, which is customized for our motherboard, this needs to be done because, you know, you have specific inputs and outputs for your motherboard. So this is specific to the motherboard, and it comes in here and it makes a closed, you know, a nice thing on the back. That makes sense. So now we're getting into mounting our motherboard into the PC case. So what I showed you there are the little pieces that will actually screw into the PC case. The PC case has three drill holes, and you have to know which ones you need to use based on the motherboard that you're using. Okay? Consult your manual, it explains all of this. But essentially, we are screwing them in. I've already kind of figured out which ones I need to use. The easy ones are the outsides, like the bottom left, the top left. You have to use those, there's no option. So those I've just set in place, and I think I use the motherboard. I just place it over top just to figure out which holes I have to use. Simple way without really doing any research. Let's see, you're building one live. Yeah, Rookie, this is all the footage. I just put this all together and now I'm showing everybody and making commentary on it. PogChamp, I like it. Woo! PogChamp! Find out what you're going to be doing, because if you spend $1,500 on a PC and the max game you want to play is Counter-Strike Go, you don't need all that power for that game, for example. You can build a PC that will do it for way less. What's up, Rookie? Yeah, you don't necessarily need to break the bank and spend $1,500 on a PC. No. What you need is a PC that's going to meet your needs. So, if you figure out what you want to do with it, like, for example, what's your target game? How graphic intensive is the game that you want to play, like you have your heart set on playing, you know? So that's the deal with the little pegs or feet or whatever their technical name is for these. We put those in place. So now we're looking at our power supply. So I decided to go, this is a 750 watt PC power and cooling power supply. PC power and cooling, they're no longer around, but this is a very quality power supply, something very stable with a high volt, you know, it's a good 12 volt rail on it for video cards, for powerful video cards, as I'll be putting in this system. And it just has everything you need, it supports everything. And on top of everything, it's a Silence series power supply. So it's actually really quiet, which is what you want these days. These days you have it all. You got a high power, high and a quiet power supply. You know, you don't want to hear the power supply. There's nothing impressive about a loud power supply. So getting it in this, I think I have to put it in a different way, actually comes in from the front of this case. This case is a little bit of a challenge. This is not for novices. I've built PCs before. I know what I'm doing. So I think, do I show it here? Let's see how I end up doing it. I'm trying to see how I can put this in. I believe I slid it in from the front. There's a little bracket there that applies some pressure on it. So we're actually lining up our power supply just like that, putting it in place. Make sure it's seated properly. Now from the back of the case, we're gonna line up the holes. Sorry, I know you guys are talking in chat. I'm trying to do two things at once. Looking for a PC, a game like Destiny. What did you do to your controller? Don't go big for your first build. Maybe, maybe not. We could talk about that. Don't go water cooling for your first build. Yes and no. Don't go with a custom water cooled rig. But a closed loop water rig, or a closed loop water cooling setup is doable. It is possible, but you have to be a little bit, you want to be a little bit handy, you know? If you're not the kind of guy who works with your hands, you know, works on cars and stuff, you know, works with technical projects, then maybe not. Just stick with the very simple stuff. But closed loop systems, which mean they come, you don't fill them, you don't have to add coolant to them, they're just good to go, you plug and play. You know, you install them and they're set. Those are not too bad to start with. So, important thing to realize what I'm doing here is I'm tightening in an X pattern. It's a cross pattern so that we get the even pressure. It pulls it back to the back of the case evenly. Okay? So you saw that I went in an X pattern. So we have our power supply in place now. We're doing great, looking great. Oops, sorry about that. Lost the image for a second. Let's see what we got. Yeah, you can do an all-in-one water cooling, also known as a closed-loop water cooling. Yeah, those are not too bad. But anyway, you can do research on it, and I'll be going over how to actually install one of those. So you can see if that's something that you would be comfortable doing. So we put our power supply in place. Now what I've already done is, you can see with the cables, this is not a modular system. So I don't have the ability to remove the cables that I don't need. But I'll be hiding them away in the back of the chassis, and it's going to look pretty clean, as you'll find out. But I ended up taking the cables and routing a majority, something like 80% of them. You can see that in that hole in the back right. Okay? So now, talking about water cooling, talking about our cooling system, we're looking at the H60. This is an entry-level water cooling system. I picked this up for $45. Really cheap. Got me into the water cooling game. Here is unboxed. We're actually unboxing it, excuse me. This is the static pressure fan that comes for the radiator. Alright, we're gonna take that out, I think, and set it aside. But this is a special fan that's designed to push air through those fins on the radiator. Okay. Now, we're gonna take a look at the system. You can see it's the hoses, it's the pump, the reservoir, and the radiator all together. It's already built together, it's put together, you don't have to do anything except unbag it and install it. So this is a closed loop system. Custom ones, you know, you have to do your own hoses, you have to do your own reservoir, you have to decide which radiator you're going to use, you have to decide with it, what individual pump, water pump you're going to use. So you have a lot of options and a lot of expenses. But this, for $45, it performs better than an air cooling setup. Okay, with a fan and heat sink. So here's our nice, pretty decently thick radiator. Not the thickest, but it's going to give us nice airflow, which is what we're looking for in this case. Okay, here is, it's actually the version 2. We have nice aerodynamic hoses on it, thick. The couplers are nice. It's just a more evolved Corsair water cooling setup. It's got a nice copper block on there. It has comes with the high quality. This is already a high performance thermal compound, ready to go. All you have to do is pop that cap off and install it. So really nice from Corsair. They've done a really good job. I've done all this research ahead of time. So here is our motherboard. We're installing it into our chassis, our PC case. You can see that those little pegs, I'm lining up the motherboard to install the screws that's going to hold down the motherboard. Okay? Now, I'm doing this one-handed. I think I end up setting the camera down or something, but just to give you an idea of what's going on and how this works, you're going to get the idea. There are 7 screws that need to be installed for the motherboard, and that's essentially, so I put the camera down. I actually did it with 2 hands, did it carefully, hold the board, put a little pressure on the board so it lines, everything lines up, and then gently screw the things down and firm, snugly put them, put the screws all the way in. Okay, so that's that step. What do we have here? Okay, so I've set I've set it all up so that I can actually do it. I put the camera down and see, it's like, and I don't have a magnetic screwdriver. A magnetic screwdriver I usually build with one. I just have this one on hand and I decided to use it. It just felt good. It was a lucky screwdriver, so I decided to use it. So you can see without the pressure applied to the motherboard, it just bounces back because of the IO plate on the back. So here I'm, you know, I'm fighting with it a little bit, working it, massaging it. I got this one in place, and you have to kind of like play around with it, be gentle, gently shift it back and forth, get everything lined up, start putting all the screws, and again, you're tightening in an X pattern, okay? So you don't want to tighten everything down just one after another, like in a row. You want to kind of tighten across the board, you know, just get gentle pressure evenly across all the mounting points. That's just how I do it, you know, just be gentle. This is a, you know, high quality, you know, electronic piece. And you want to be gentle and you want to do it the right way. How many PCs have I built before this one? Well, I've probably built about 5 PCs before this one, you know? I have a good amount of experience. I've helped other people build them. I've trained people. I put together 5 complete ones. That's not to say, you know, whenever you do an upgrade to a PC, you're always opening up your PC case, unscrewing something, pulling it out. You're always kind of working in it, but you're not doing a complete PC build. The complete PC build is kind of like you need all the skills. You need to use your whole toolkit, you know, and use your whole brain too. But it's fun. So we've got our motherboard down. You know, I've taken a look at everything. Now I'm kind of sizing up. I'm saying, okay, here we go. We're going to install our Corsair fan. It's going to be used in the rear. So I'm thinking about my airflow in the case. And I've already thought about this a month ahead of time. I already knew I was going to install this exact fan. Okay? And that means to say that, and what I'm saying is, I'm installing this in an exhaust configuration, which is very typical for this spot. But what's not typical is when you do an air cooling, what the manual will recommend and what Corsair recommends is to use these in an intake configuration, meaning drawing air in. But I'm actually drawing air out of the rear. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be installing that fan in place, and I'm also going to be installing the radiator right on that fan. And the screws are going to go through the fan, and they're going to go into the radiator, and it's going to pull it back onto the PC case. So that's what's going to happen right now. So I need to get everything lined up, get all the screws ready to go, and then I'm going to start putting it in. So here we go, we're going to be careful, we're going to be really gentle with these hoses. One of the things in my research is these hoses, you have to be gentle, or because the things that hold the hoses together are a little bit, you know, you have to be gentle with them or they could break. So just be really soft and really slow, you know, try to be really careful. So I'm not trying to put any pressure in it, I'm not trying to hit the thing against anything, I'm just like trying to be as gentle as I can. Lining it up, going through the radiator there. So here we go, we're going again in a cross tightening pattern. So once I put the bolts in, we're just putting all the bolts in place. There's four of them. Actually, little washers are used on the rear. So you have a washer and a bolt, and it goes through the fan into the radiator, and it holds everything nice and tight. And just the top of the radiator there was really close to the chassis, the lip on the case. So I just needed to be gentle and get it in place, line everything up, and make sure everything fit right. And everything fit very well. It was a little bit tight, but it fit. Having such a good time, man. I just have been wanting to build this PC for so long. You guys on the PC can scroll down and see all the specifications of my PC. I happily put them all down there in the description, down there in the on the panels on my channel. Super happy. I got a nice monitor, nice keyboard, and a nice mouse. I'll talk about those after. So we put everything, tightened it all up, got it all nice and snug in there. Next step. Okay, so we have our block. Alright? So that is the, actually, this is the bracket for the back, okay? We're starting with the bracket from the back, just because chronologically. So I had to go to the hardware store and I had to buy these white plastic washers because, and here it is, here they are, nylon, whatever, plastic washers. Corsair didn't pull their head out of their ass. There's people online on the forums complaining about this problem, that it just does not have enough spacing to allow you to tighten the bolts or the little nuts on there, so to hold it down on the motherboard, on the back plate there. It just doesn't tighten down right unless you space it out. So I'm actually just quick disassembling these little plastic pieces on here. Not a big deal, you can actually put all this together without doing this, but I didn't leave any detail unturned. I really went through this computer, I wanted this computer to be bulletproof and built right, so I didn't spare any, you know, expense or detail, really, in my opinion, how I wanted to build it. So we put these spacers in place. I actually ended up using two instead of one, but that's what we're doing. Okay, good question. why did I do a exhaust configuration instead of an intake? Why did I decide to have the air pulling out? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly show you our chassis, right? Take a look at the fan of the top of our PC case. We have a massive, massive fan. This is an exhaust fan because, as you know in physics, the heat will rise out the top of our case. So the airflow simply comes in from the front and from the bottom, cold intake air. Coming out the rear and the top, we're using an exhaust setup. That's where we want our hot air to flow. So we're getting a diagonal airflow across the components, through everything, out the back and out the top. And that's how that works. And that's why I decided to do it. This is a tight case. The airflow, you have to be masterful with the airflow in this case. Okay? So, back to our backplate. Basically, we did the spacers. You know, I still had to finick around with it. There's actually, you had to move those little things to get it to sit in there. I didn't want to sit in place. I needed two hands. This actually needs to sit there, and you go around to the other side, and you're going to actually screw down the things that hold it in place. So, and you also want to be careful here. You see, you notice that there are two screws on the back plate at the top and one screw at the bottom. The two screws are very tight against that bracket. So the bracket has the orientation of the bracket has to be correct so that those little cutouts will be at the top. See that? Okay, so that's installed, ready to go. Now we're going back to the other side. I've taken the liberty to put two of these little feet, these little pegs, in already. I'm screwing down the other two to demonstrate it to you how it's done. Alright, so with those spacers, we've got a nice, tight, proper screw. It's got the right amount of distance so that you can actually tighten it down, and everything is nice and tight, and the correct spacing and everything. Alright, so we're checking, again, we're doing a cross-tightening. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We are cross-tightening. That's how that works. Again, it's a very important thing whenever you're doing one of these installs, okay? So now we're taking our little mounting bracket that goes on top. It actually clicks down in place very tight, very nice. I just set it there for demonstration purposes. And one of the things that I want to mention right now, I want to stop and mention this. If you notice, this is already plugged in. This plugs into our fan connections on the motherboard. There's two. There's one for the fan on the radiator, and there's one that goes directly into this block that is going to be for the water pump. Okay, the instructions tell you to install, to put these connections and make the connections last, but the instructions are, again, doing research on videos and online, you actually want to put these things in now, because later it's really hard. It's a pain in the ass. So think about where these wires are going to be routed and go ahead and plug those cables in. Okay? Let's check the chat here, guys. Thank you, everybody, for joining me. I really appreciate you guys watching my stream. Hit that follow button if you haven't for this awesome. I'm going to continue here. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Nice to have you here. I hope you're enjoying it. All right, so here is our radiator, and we're putting in the block. So we're installing the block on top of the CPU. We're installing our water block and our heat sink. It's all in one. Now here is a critical move. I've taken the cap off. I've exposed the thermal compound. You're going to see what I do. I line up the block, line it up, and instantly I lay it down, and I apply pressure to it. One shot. And now I'm holding the pressure down with my hand while I'm tightening this up. I'm going to put four screws on. That's one right there in the corner. There's three in the other corners. I'm continuing to hold this. A lot of people, even Corsair's stupid video instructions, has the fucking block moving around left and right, up and down, all kinds of shit. I'm continuing to apply pressure. This is very important that you do this. Because if you do that, if you don't, this is going to move around and you're going to create air bubbles in your thermal compound. And it's going to be, you're just not going to have a good contact with your processor. And that could lead to overheating, okay? Definitely, the performance of your processor with the cooling capability is hinging upon you making a good thermal connection here, okay? I just wanted to stress that. So that's basically done, though. I didn't want to scare anybody. It's easy. You just push it down and make sure it doesn't move. You tighten everything up. And you're done. So there it is installed. I carefully thought about how the hoses were going to be routed. You have options on that stuff. You see that massive fan at the top. So now you're seeing an L shape, where the airflow is coming across all of our components, and it's actually going to be exhausting the heat out. So let's move on to our solid state hard drive. So I decided to go with the Mushkin Kronos. It's a 240 gigabyte solid state drive, high performance. It's all flash memory, no moving parts, lightweight, pretty inexpensive, good deal. You know, just hook it up like a regular hard drive. We have like a 550 the data speed of it. The reads and the writes are about 550, somewhere around there. The maximum that this hard drive connection can do is 600. So we're right at the maximum performance. So this drive is a killer deal for the money. Tons of space to start out with. You can expand, you can get another SSD, another hybrid drive, or you can go with a regular hard drive. You got a lot of options, but this is gonna get us going. Get us right on the road, all right? Look at this graphics card. Double dissipation R9 290X, engineered by XFX. XFX, man. This is the fucking card right here. 4 gigabytes of DDR5 RAM. You know, the Radeon series card that just performs. So this thing is gonna rock and roll, man. Just a beast of a card. Here it is, right out of the box, in its protective pouch. We're going to take it right out of that. We're going to take a look at it right now. Here is the XFX card. Go for a little tour. Nice thick heatsink on there. Double high-performance quiet fans on it with a proprietary fan design. You know, it's an 8 and 6 pin power connection. Massive card. Four connections on it for video. You got dual DVI, an HDMI, and the new, or I don't know, the one that they're using now. It's a, you know, a high performance connection they have. And basically, this thing has you know, nice heat sinks on there, and it has the XFX lights up. Really cool. It's got, you can't really tell, but the white letters on it glow when you fire this card up. It's really sick. So, let's take a look. This is the back of the card. I mean, it's kind of beautiful. The way everything is laid out. The 3D-ness to it. A lot of people like a backplate. Which makes it nice and smooth. It's nice for airflow, and it's kind of nice for looks, if not a little plain. But this is kind of the old way of doing it, just exposing it, providing a little bit of cooling from ambient air, and just showing off the card, you know? So here's our hard drive. We're going back to it. I know we're jumping. But that's just the order that I had it in. I decided to mount my hard drive here. I have a Blu-ray drive also that I just set in place there. But basically screw it down, install the connections, plug and play. Very simple. We need to make our power connections on the motherboard. So we're putting in the 8-pin connector at the top here. I got these really nice individual sleeved extensions. You can see how nice that looks in there to match our red and black theme. There is our main power cable that goes on the board. Boom, bam, plug it in, good to go, just like that. I'm gonna show it one more time. Really sick details. So let's take a look here. Back to, I don't know, I didn't install the video card yet. It wasn't time. So we need to plug in. There's three things. There's a USB 3.0 header that allows the connectors on the front of the computer to work. There is a HD audio cable. That's the one on the bottom, the long one, going to the left. That gets plugged in on the left here. Boom. And then you have on the right, it's actually power switch, reset switch, and a hard drive indicator light, I believe. Those just get plugged in there. Boom. Just gotta complete it. Gotta make that happen or else it won't work. Finally, back to our graphics card. We're just carefully lining it up, see how it fits, those kinds of things. So here, you know, is our PCI Express slot that we're going to be putting it into. You just got to gently get the rear to play. I think those little caps on the back made it so I can't install it. So what I ended up doing was taking the caps off, the covers on the connectors, and I installed the card, and then I just put those caps back on, the ones I'm not going to be using. But this is just to demonstrate the installation. You can see that I've removed the caps now, and I can get the rear things in place. I can gently put it in place here. Lock it down. I want to talk about something, a big mistake, in my opinion, that builders make. I've actually laid the PC down on its back, and I'm directly inserting the card straight down. So, a lot of builders on YouTube or whatever, you know, they might have be good or whatever, but they install the card sideways. It puts a lot of pressure on this. Usually doesn't make any harm, but I just don't like to do it. It's not the way I've ever built it. Not the way I was taught, essentially. And so what you want to do is you want to apply it downwards. You want to hold it in place, and you want to screw it down, the two screws on the back. My 360's hard drive is 340. Yeah, but we're not talking about hard drive space. We're talking about hard drive performance. This SSD will blow your hard drive out of the water. Totally extreme speed because it's flash memory. It's booting the entire computer, your games, your utilities, everything right off of this SSD. Everything comes up in a snap. Ultra durable, it's not susceptible to being moved around. So you have, it's just a totally different class of hard drive space. Hard drive storage solutions. So you can see I've replaced the caps in the back. You can see how that put the little things in place there. You can see how it sits in there. Alright, so we've plugged in the car to the motherboard. Now we're taking our power connections, we're putting in the 8-pin, and we're putting in the 6-pin, and we're making those power connections. I've already plugged them in, but I'm demonstrating how those plug in right there. Boom, boom, 1, 2. Now you have the card is getting the power from the motherboard, and it's such a powerful card that it requires not even one power connection, but 2. It's a powerhouse card. So, properly connected, ready to go. You can see that I've connected our solid state hard drive on the right. Power connection, done. Data connection, done. Power on the left, data on the right. And you can also see the USB 3.0 cable has been installed up in the middle area of the screen. You can see that the connectors on the bottom have been installed and routed. Everything is routed clean at this point. And you can see the way I've decided to go with the power connections on the motherboard. I went for a flowing design where the individual cables will actually flow over everything. Give it kind of a matrix kind of look, you know? It's clean and functional at the same time. And here we go, guys. You can see that we put a PC together. All the power connections are made. Our water cooling setup has been installed. There's our video card, ready, happy, ready to go. We got our power supply feeding everything. Plug in the fans. That's it. Just plug the fans in. And, the way it's going to be set up is we're going to put 2 intake fans on the front, and it's going to draw air directly in. One is going to be supplying. This is the way it's going to be set up. We have one fan on the bottom of the front doing the power supply, the other fan at the top doing the radiator right there, straight into the top radiator. And there's actually a third fan that's being mounted on the side window that is feeding cold air straight into the graphics card. So we have a triple intake fan setup that, you know, I've developed this over a long period of time, thought about how I wanted to build this. It's ready to rock, man. It's just fantastic. That's our PC, guys. I've built it all for you, talked about everything, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching that. I do appreciate you guys watching. You guys are totally awesome. I'm really excited about this. You guys got me even more excited than I was before I started. I'm just happy to show this.